what drummers who are playing now have really impressed you?
Well, I had the honor of working with John McIntyre on this last record. And for us to even be in correspondence with him was a really big thing. And now, I can consider him a friend. So that was massive for me, since he is actually one of my favorite drummers, and I'm heavily influenced by him. So, and he's going to be playing with us tonight. So that was absolutely a dream.
Yeah. I noticed that a lot of tracks on the album featured him on drums as well.
Yeah.
How did that work out? At the same time or layered?
Some of the parts are doubled. He doubled me on some stuff, like in World Sick. He doubled me on some of those parts just to beef it up a little bit.
Yeah.
I think he recorded his drums in a different room, in a different way, with a different setup. Some songs he is, one song, I'm Grateful Little Father, he's playing the main drum part on that. He's playing the main drum part on Andrew Whiteman's song, Hard Head's Drummer. But he sort of skipped the keys on that one. So yeah, it was sort of like a, on some songs it was doubled and some were not doubled. Some are just separate parts that complement each other.
Was there any tricks, any techniques of his that you really picked up on?
If I did, it wasn't really anything specific. I think it was more just subliminal. Because it's not like I knew the guy when I was growing up listening to his records to be like, how did you do that? So you just sort of, like I said, sometimes subliminally or sometimes actually trying to dissect the part. You just sort of, you translate it in your own way and you approach it. Just mimic the sound.
Yeah.
The sound is the destination as opposed to the how.
What are some of the challenges of playing anchor mode 9, 10, 11?
Anchoring the stage sound.
Yeah.
Telling people to turn down a lot. Getting in-ears for the first time ever on this tour has helped me a lot. So I can just dial in what I wanted, and everything else is just pretty much non-existent. So it's almost like I'm pretending that the stage sound is taken care of, but it's just taken care of in my own head. So it's definitely a challenge. But it's a good challenge.
And how do you envision your role in the band, recording and when you guys play live?
How do you mean?
Well, you touched on anchoring
right. The
band.
Yeah.
Does that carry over into you're the driver, or
right.
does that carry into you drop the set list, things
right.
like that?
Oh, right. Actually, yeah, well, me and Kevin, we do the set list together, because we're sticklers for even like record sequence and just the general flow of songs. Sometimes I don't like certain songs to be just for either like stamina reasons, because it can be a little exhausting, or just for general flow, or certain beats are similar, so I like to keep them separate. So I guess I'm one of the conductors in a weird sort of way. It seems weird to say that, but I'm just really fucking stubborn when it comes to my band. I'm really specific about how I think things should be, and so I really don't censor myself in my point of view. Sometimes you have to be just tweaking the reveal because there's a lot of people to report to. So I'm the annoying guy.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. I would be a drummer, universal drummer character.
Yeah, just annoying.
What are some of your drumming strengths?
I have no idea. You should let me know after the show.
Okay.
I don't know if I have any at all.
One thing I really like, signature Justin Peroff move for me, which I don't really remember hearing a lot until one of the first Broken Social Scene records was do chat.
Yeah.
And three.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And three.
Yeah.
Where'd that come from?
I think I first did that in Stars and Suns during that breakdown of Stars and Suns. And I think it was a combination of that pattern. But I think it was made clear due to David Mufon's production. He's a big fan of the drums, and he's a big fan of my drumming, and he makes me sound way better than I actually am. And with a lot of the compressors that he uses, and the way that the mics are situated, and the way that he turns up certain mics that are kind of like way over there on the thread of the ear, there's other sort of patterns and nuances that reveal themselves due to his production. So yeah. I think originally it was that, and then after listening back, I guess, to my own record, I was like, oh, I guess that's a pattern that I do. I just started to deal with that.
Forgiveness necessarily.